Hello, my name's Robert Dean Steele, and this is your Cornerstone Community Church service for January 16th, 2022. And we're so glad that you can join us for this service. We're going to open our time with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you today for another opportunity to spend time together. We ask that, Lord, you'd bless, of course, today, the songs that are sung, and also as well, the word that is presented from Ephesians. Now, we ask all of these things in Jesus' name, amen. Well, I want to give you a personal invitation. We have an in-person service. That is at Cornerstone Hall, number 6, Taché Street in downtown St. Albert. Our doors open at 10:45, and our service starts at 11 a.m. And we're going to start off with a great song called Hosanna, and let's enjoy this together. I see the King of Glory coming on the clouds with fire. The whole world shakes, the whole world shakes. I see his love and mercy washing over all our sins. The people sing, the people sing. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna. In selfless faith, in selfless faith. I see a near revival stirring as we pray and see. We're on our knees, we're on our knees. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Heal my heart and make me clean. Unseen, show me how to love like you have loved me. Break my heart with what breaks yours. Everything I am for your kingdom cause. As I walk from earth into eternity, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna. Well, that is certainly a wonderful thing to be able to do, to be able to say, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Well, we got another great song here. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks
to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. Give thanks.
Now it is an absolute privilege to be able to give thanks in everything. And that's what Paul brings about. Now, in just a moment, we're going to share with you from Ephesians chapter 6. We're going to be looking at 23 and 24. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you today for what Paul is going to be sharing with us today from Ephesians chapter 6, 23 and 24. We ask your blessing upon this word and about that which is shared. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, let me just put my guitar aside for just a moment. This is what he says. In the last two verses, he says, peace to the brothers and love with faith from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. So there's something that Paul wants to see brought forward in these final words. Now, he's been talking to the Ephesians, of course, in different aspects. In fact, he has three different prayers in this book. Also, as well, he reveals proper relationships with husbands and wives and with children. All of this is because of the fact that he was teaching these individuals what the Christian life is all about. Now, the interesting fact is that this book was written from jail, and through all of it, he never says anything, you know, negative about his situation. In fact, he considered himself a prisoner of the Lord Jesus Christ. That was the reason why he was in prison. He understood that even though he was bound in a Roman jail, he was truly free in Jesus Christ. Now, this is what he says in verse 23. He says, I want peace to bring to all the brethren. He says, I want absence of conflict, personal warfare, not happening in the church, but also as well in our individual lives and situations. That is the marvelous thing. One of the benefits, of course, of serving the Lord is having peace in your heart. And also it says in the Sermon on the Mount and the Beatitudes, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the sons of God. Now, one of the things that Paul made very clear here in the book of Ephesians was that we were the sons of God. And so as the sons of God, we are blessed when we bring peace, or that absence of peace and conflict in our lives, to those which we have in our life situation. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 11:23, that which I receive, I pass unto you. He knew that it was absolutely essential that we would walk in the peace that passes all understanding, that we would have our hearts and our minds guarded in Christ Jesus today. He also said, I want love from faith, with faith from God, the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. So he says this, we know that love is the is the foundation. Of course, that was taught in 1 Corinthians 13:13, that love is the foundation of faith. And faith is actually brought, increased and grown through the word of God. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But all of these are from the Father and also from the Son. And I want you to notice something here. He also said the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, what Paul wanted to do was he said, listen, God is love. And Jesus Christ is the avenue in which this love comes. But you also need to realize that Jesus isn't just Savior. He is Lord. Lord means master. And then our responsibility is to be his instruments and ambassadors of peace, his ambassadors of love. And all of it is because of our duty, our obligation, and our love for the Lord Jesus Christ. That is who he is. He's our master. He is the object of our worship. He is the avenue in which we have received this wonderful gift of salvation. And as well, he is the one who is directing us as the church. He is the head of the church. And that's what Paul brought out in this book. Also, he says, grace to all who love our Lord Jesus Christ with an undying love. So there are three things that we're going to look up for just a moment. First of all, we are going to have that grace, that unmerited favor, that ability to be able to go and be and become everything that Jesus Christ and everything that God intended in our life situation. Also as well, we have all the riches of heaven. That's God's riches at Christ's expense, excuse me, because of the Lord Jesus Christ. And that is so exciting today. And he says, let this grace, to all who love the Lord Jesus Christ. There's that word again, the Lord Jesus Christ, with an undying love. Now, of course, this was the quality of the church that Paul was addressing at the time. Now, unfortunately, what can happen is we can actually lose our undying love. You say, how can that happen? Well, that's what happened to the Ephesian church. In Revelation chapter 2, Jesus said, the only thing I have against you is you've forgotten your first love. So how did this happen? Well, it can easily happen when we neglect such a great salvation. And this is exhortation and a warning that we need to keep our love for the Lord fresh by having a daily relationship with God, by walking with him moment by moment, hour by hour, day by day, not allowing a single opportunity to worship, an opportunity to spend time with God in his word or in prayer or going to the house of the Lord or sharing our faith. These are the four foundations that will enable us to keep ourselves in that place of undying love. And it will also keep the reality of the grace of God in our life situation. And we need to continually refresh and refire our love. You see, the love of God flows into us all the time. In fact, the Bible says that we're to love the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love our neighbor as ourselves. That love is constantly pouring into our life situation. But what we need to do is make a decision to keep it flowing with freshness. We don't want to drink out of waters or out of cisterns that are broken. We want to have that fresh flowing water. You know, one of the beauties of a mountain stream is its constant movement. There is no opportunity for the water to be contaminated because it keeps flowing. And that is the beauty of a fresh relationship with God. And that's what he wants. He wants peace in your life. He wants you to walk in faith. He wants you to have grace, and he wants you to walk with undying love towards the Lord. That is the exhortation that Paul is giving. And it all comes from God, who is love, and through the avenue of the Lord Jesus Christ. And again, twice he uses the word the Lord Jesus Christ. He wants to establish the lordship of Jesus Christ in your life. He wants you to realize that, yes, Jesus is Lord or the Savior, but he is Lord as well. And when we recognize that, then all of a sudden we say, yes, I am in the Lord's army. Jesus got a wonderful lesson when he went to minister to the centurion's servant. And what the centurion gave him was a really wonderful illustration. That's an illustration for us too, as well. When Jesus was heading there, the man sent a message and said, just say the word and my servant will be healed. And he said, I am a man under authority. He says, when I give a message, I tell my soldiers what to do, they do it. And he says, when I am told what to do, I do it. And Jesus said, this man has demonstrated more faith than all the people in Israel, because Jesus in that moment recognized that we are doing the will of our Father, and we are under obligation, or we're under duty, whatever you want to call it, to do the will of our Father. Jesus did that, and he understood, this man understood obedience. This man understood that he was under authority, and we are under the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. And when we are under the authority of Jesus Christ, we are going to allow through our lives the peace that passes all understanding. The world can't give it and the world can't take it away. We'll understand that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. We will understand that we are to love one another because it's an illustration of God's character, nature, and essence in our lives. And lastly, that we are to have that grace, that wonderful ability to be able to overcome every situation. The grace of God is that wonderful attribute of God that allows us to live our life to the fullest. That is the message that Jesus and Paul was giving to us today. So, Father, we thank you again for the wonderful Word of God. And we thank you, Lord, for the messages that we can get out of this and the applications as well. We ask that, Lord, right now in Jesus' name, that in this moment, we will choose to make you the Lord of our lives, that we would allow these wonderful attributes of grace, of love, of mercy, and also of peace to flow through our lives. Lord, also today, we're going to make a commitment in the first part of this year that, Lord, we're going to follow you with an undying love. Thank you for that today. Now, as well, right now in this moment, if you have a need or I need for a healing, I want to leave you with two thoughts. The first one is that 1 Peter 2:24 and Isaiah 53 verse number 5 are these wonderful scriptures that we stand on that says, by his stripes we're healed. So whether your need is physical, spiritual, emotional, intellectual, financial, or family, large or small, God can meet that right now. Also as well, I want to remind you that he is Jehovah Jireh. And Philippians chapter 4, verse number 19 says that our God will supply every need according to his riches and glory. So right now, we're going to pray that God's going to supply your need. So Father, once again, we thank you today for the wonderful opportunity to pray one for another. Lord, we're praying for those that need healing right now in the name of Jesus. You are Jehovah Rophi or Rapha, depending on how we view it, but you are our healer right now. Whether we find ourselves at home or in hospital, no matter what we're facing, we claim it. Also as well, we claim it for those that we love today. Also as well, Lord, thank you today for your provision. Every need is being supplied right now. And like the old song says, Lord, we're receiving right now. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Well, I'd like to sing you another song. And that is, of course, the one that says, ever let it be that I would praise you. It's a great song. As we close today, let's worship the Lord.
Ever let it be that I would praise you. Ever let it be that I would please you. Ever let it be that I would praise your name. Never let it be that I would turn away. Ever let it be that I would love you. Never let there be any gods above you. Never let it be that I would sing your praise. Never let it be that I would praise you. Ever let it be that I would please you. Never let it be that I would turn away. Ever let it be that I would love you. Never let there be any gods above you. Never let it be that I would sing your praise.
That's what it should be. Ever let it be that we would serve you with every fiber of our being. Well, I want to thank you for spending time with me today. And I want to invite you to our in-person service that we have every Sunday. We meet at Cornerstone Hall. We, of course, are Cornerstone Community Church. Our address of our meeting place is number 6 Taché Street in downtown St. Albert. And we would love to have you join us. Our service time is at 11 a.m. and our doors open at 10:45. Thank you. Now, Lord, we ask your blessing upon our time together and your word. And we thank you, Lord, for each and every single opportunity. We ask your blessing in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you and have yourself a great and godly day.